Hello, this is Matt Wright. Apologize for being a little late. This was taking care of a few things around the house as everybody was in the news. I was looking over the list of callers as I first brought up the studio here on Blog Talk. And I did as I always do. Sometimes I got curious a lot of the pastures I've had. Because sometimes I don't. This world away. I sense intuitively it should. And looking over it, a whole burst of numbers had just come up, and then they disappeared after I started talking about the phone numbers, just like the duplicate 336 area code numbers. One with the whole time of 658, another one, the 701 and 339, the same 336-629 number, right next to each other. And I mean, things like this had happened before. I mean, I expect it. But you know that if something like that happens, there's something to it. And they know. And they know it. And they know I know. But it's cool. I'm going to go to everybody because it's cool to have it on record. All the stuff that goes on like I remember one, I did a whole show where I just took on new co-hosts one after another based on people who called in and if they possess a certain energy. And like I've talked about before, it's been 9 or 10 at once. And those were cool shows on the spiritual science channel. But anyway, I've already learned who's patient and for the people who've called, and get used to it. Let me just say this, I'm very blunt. I don't hold anything back. And I'm going to say it the way it is. See the duplicate numbers. I gotta admire the fact that they stayed on there. And they're staying on there. Wow. Given the, it's obvious there's something there. Right. It's just going to be interesting trying to pick, the first person, I have this, I think that's probably the best way of this. Roll with it, whatever pops up to mind to do. Go ahead and roll with that particular one and then that's what came we should do it a little bit. So what to do. So here we go. Are you there?
Hello?
Hi, Eden, how are you
Hello?
doing? Yeah, can
All
you
right,
hear me?
good. Yeah. I took you off speaker. Sorry.
Oh, no problem, no problem.
I came out feels like out here where I'm at. A lot of stuff going on. But I would really appreciate, just kind of a general reading for me.
So you stepped outside to assess what was going on. You said, "This is what I'm
Yeah,
assuming."
just
So
that,
let's
I mean,
roll with
it's the weather's nice here. I'm safe, but all around, at least I'm safe
it.
from the
Do you feel good
weather.
about what you do? Do you feel good about what you do in life? I mean, does it make you happy? You know, your career, your like, you know, the things you've done and other jobs and whatnot.
No.
Like,
no.
It does.
No, I'm not in a good spot right now. I've got to, I'm having to get disability, but, you know, they keep putting me off. And so finances are really bad, and it makes me mad that I don't, you know, that I'm not well enough to be able to go help anybody, or I feel kind of worthless as far as that goes, you know?
But I wasn't talking about, like, the stat. Like, I mean, I was talking about, like the greater picture of your life, yeah, as a whole. Like, you know, what things you've done for a living don't satisfy you. They haven't satisfied you, right? Right. You know, and you're looking for that, that happiness where work isn't work. It's fun to do. It's like something you're playing with. You know, something that you're excited to do, and not something a person dreads. And work can be anything. It could be anything. Walking down the street, like trusting your intuition to help people. Like, I've been on the bus, riding the bus before several times. Like, and a spirit sometimes will appear and ask me if I'll say this or that to this or that person, you know, to a stranger on somewhere else in the bus, and I do. And, something will come intuitive, but I just get up and tell them, I don't hold back, you know. And you can't hold back your collective thought and intelligent creative energy, but you have them. Do you understand where I'm going with this?
Right. No, I mean, I understand what you're saying. I just get for practically right now. I'm not sure how I'm going to get through what I'm going through. I've got a lot of people against me.
What makes you think they're against you?
It's not a matter of think. It's a matter of know. It's a fact. Problems
but
with
how
the
do you,
association
how do
where I live. How do I know that? Because they say it. Because they send me bills that are unjust. You know.
I was talking about,
I mean,
like,
it's
you know, in general, not just like in general with people.
Well, that's what I'm. You know, right now. Right now, that's kind of my most important thing because it's a matter of survival. You know, I'm kind
the
of
association
on
the
survival run.
The association
what?
Is a matter as a matter of survival.
Yeah, they're trying to take my house. They're trying to take my home. You
that's
know?
What I'm talking
and,
about.
So
that's
it's a matter. Yeah. Yeah.
That's
and
what you
and
call
it's
it.
Unjust,
that's
but.
That.
Right.
Because you're late on,
right.
on the payment, right? And you know, like, and you run into
but
the
I don't owe it. They, yeah, I don't owe it. I don't owe it. They owe me lots of money and lots of repairs that they've never done. And so that's, you know, they just want to try to get me out instead
well, they,
of fixing
the
what they destroyed.
Agreed on? Well, were the repairs
what?
Agreed upon? Were the repairs agreed?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's
on, with,
oh, yeah.
On, with the
contract?
It's,
yeah, there's laws. Yeah, exactly. Yes,
but,
and it was
but
proven
it,
in court.
But it's about, like, it, if someone's late on payments, like, or, like,
no,
that the services are not.
No. It's been going on for years.
Well, that's what I'm talking about. Like, you say that they owe you repairs.
Yeah, they're watching for me. This is great.
It's the same
thing.
They
can't
thing,
see me
yeah.
in my house. They come drive around looking for me.
And
yeah.
So
no, it's
I'm trying to help you, and I'm, this is how it comes to me sometimes to tell the people. It's very important.
Okay.
I've got to be, you know, like to get through sometimes. Like, I roll with whoever comes to me. Even though that might seem harsh to certain people.
I just don't really want to go through the whole thing and take up all your time. It's just,
taking up my time. Like, I understand where you're coming from. I've been trying to tell you how to get out of the situation.
Yeah, but I already know. Okay, my daughter's a lawyer. My daughter is a lawyer. I went to court.
Mm-hmm.
I won in court. They were supposed to fix these things, and they aren't. So that's what I'm talking about.
I know that. But what if they, you're fighting like an entity that could
the association.
Got the money to spend to tie someone up in court on appeals and all this other stuff for years and cost them money, legal bills, and all this other stuff. I'd like asking stuff like that. Like, with
sure.
With,
well, that's why I tried to not do it that way, you know? But it's been several years, and they haven't done it, and so.
But it started with the payment, and then other
things. No. It
said
didn't.
It earlier, right?
It didn't. I've paid for 35 years. Okay, I was paying.
Yeah, but they can foreclose. Like,
listen, I'm gonna let you go. Okay, bye.
See, I knew that was a minion, you know, even, like, but I took the call anyway. Like, that's why, I went with intuition, you know. I knew that, that's why I asked her, are you happy with, what you're doing for a living? I mean, are you happy with it? She said, no, it's right on recording. And see, I told her the truth, and everybody who's listening now knows that. And I'm not going to bullshit people. I mean, I'm always blunt, but language is language. That's the way I look at it. And one time there was a show I did, it was like in 2012, I think. Yeah, 2012. And I knew somehow, it just came to me intuitively that the show was going to be full of pawns calling it. Oppo troll pawns. And I was like, screw it. I'm not going to sit here and bother this. With the scan every single number deeply. I'm just going to roll off the first impressions and go from that. Even though they might be screwed, we'll put them on. And I did it. And it was, a bunch of trolls. And I was like, now I know I'm doing it on the right path again. When you're out there, has people on their side, sheeple controlled, you could say, trying to disrupt truth. And just bear with me. Just bear with me, y'all. Everybody's all. Just bear with me for a minute or two more. I just had to say that about that particular call. That people know it's truth, and some people can't handle it. And if they can't, they can't. So I'm a stressor. But anyway, let's continue. Yeah, let's see, first impression. Hello, are you there?
Hi.
Hello.
This is Michelle. Hello?
Yeah, I'm here. How are you doing tonight?
Good, how are you?
I'm fine.
That's good. I was wondering if you see any love in my future?
Any loss?
Love.
Is that
love.
What you said? Any snow? I mean, like, okay. Snow.
What'd you say?
Is that what you asked? What?
No, I said love. Any relationships?
Okay, the thing was breaking up. And it sounded like something else. Okay.
Sorry.
What stressed about finding love and relationship?
Because
I
recently broke up with somebody.
But the thing is, though, when somebody breaks up with somebody, whoever it might be, when there's a breakup, it's for a reason. I tell everybody that who asks, that. You know, in a relationship, whether it's a official marriage, as you might call it, or just a, boyfriend-girlfriend relationship, or whatever it might be, that you have to, each partner has to have a break, even if it's just for a few hours away from one.
Yeah.
And if they're always around each other, every minute of every day. And to make it worse, one of them is sitting there kissing the other's ass, trying to please the woman. But that's what I keep telling this particular person. And he knows too. I mean, it's nothing about the women, nothing bad about women in general. It's just that that's what's going on. He's kissing too much ass. And he knows better. But he says, it doesn't have to be like that. And it could be with a man. A man could be rude to his wife, his girlfriend, and just go off. Vice versa could happen with the woman. And
right.
I'm just thinking about relationships because a lot of people have called in about this. I feel it coming. There's more people calling about the same subject to come up, later on. And so therefore, I'm thinking about it, how to help the greater good of people via trying to understand what makes you think in the beginning that you need a relationship and love? What is it
I kind of think I'm not even ready for one. I guess I just want to make sure. I guess I just want to know that, I feel like, I'm getting old and, maybe. I guess I just want to know that I will have one eventually, even if I'm not ready now.
I never said you weren't ready. I never said you weren't ready, but I said I just felt why. I get it. It's just thinking. A lot of people think about age and that. You're not one. And what I tell them is what I mean when I say what makes you think you need love in that form. What taught you that in the first place? Look at society's teaching that you're getting older, you got to find a man, you got to have a family, pressure. I've seen that happen in families. I've talked to people who've been under pressure like that from relatives. It's amazing to me that people could go through that, but you've been through that, been through one thing, and then that doesn't work out, then it's the next one, and then that fails. It's a cycle. And you go day in and day out, but like frustrated with that and frustrated with the job and things that happen there with certain things. You're not happy all the way with the, just like the other person. I really sense that now. And just not, you know, you want something in you is like, I need a change. And I need happiness. And where am I going to get it, right?
And
you saw that?
I didn't hear. Yeah, I'm having a hard time hearing everything you're saying for some reason. It's like it, I don't know, some words I can hear of you and some words I can't. I'm going to put headphones on and see if that works better.
What did it sound like?
It kind of sounds like you're like muffled a little bit or something.
And it was clear before, you said, right? And then it's muffled?
The other lady was on, I could hear her, but I couldn't hear you very good. So I missed part. I know something happened, and I know she hung up, but I wasn't even sure, like, who was saying what for some reason.
Yeah, I knew it was one of their pawns, you know. But yet intuition was like, well, it's screwed if it, you know, because I was expecting that, you know. And sometimes, like, you know, intuition says, like, go ahead, put a pawn on, even though you know that, you know, like, and announce it on the air before you do it, you know, like, I've done that before, when it comes up, because it does, right, because it's true, you know. I said to people, like, some of the stuff I've seen and gone through, like, they wouldn't believe it. Like, you know, it would be a make a great movie that people would love. But if people realize that it was real, and it is real, it happens to a lot of people, some of these things, you know. And with you worry too much anxiety, too much trying to please other people. You understand?
Yeah.
It's just the way, I could see it, the way you were brought up, you know, to make people happy. Like, it's almost like your mother or grandmother, maybe, but like a figure like that, or a figure like someone figuratively like a mother or grandmother, like teaching like their granddaughters this or that. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do.
It's something in your life too, and like that train, I can see the question is almost like, how do you overcome the train? It's like schools train and program kids.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like, look at the worksheets at home or quizzes they get, the questions that are on. And I'm looking at certain textbooks. I mean, I've seen a lot of examples like that people put up online over the years. And some of it is like, you know, government officials always obey their orders no matter what. If someone says they're an official, like, and that's in a elementary school, homework assignment from a textbook. And that was on my mind in 2013. And there's other examples. And I tell people, question everything. Trust nothing all the way. It's, you know, almost like the X-Files motto. It is X-Files motto with one more word added, trust no one completely. Best way to go about things sometimes.
Yeah.
Will you have love? Yes, if you open your heart. That's what I get. But, you know, I see a vision of that. You have to open your heart to it. And you're too worried about losing at the moment. If you can get over the fear of losing one and embrace it, and so you'll be
What did you say I'm too worried about?
Like, the more you worry about it, if you're going to find someone, the less likely it is you're going to find that person. Because the worry pushes away the result you're looking for. The universe takes it literally. And you get what I'm saying. I feel it.
That makes sense.
You get it.
And
it's hard. That's not the result you're looking for. You're looking for at like exact time, but the exact time depends on you, on your actions.
Okay. No, that makes sense.
I know it does. I know, but it's hard for people a lot, and just do that. Yeah, sometimes I've seen a lot of examples. So, but you can do it. You can do it. Anybody can. And I'm just saying this for the benefit of everybody, you know. But think about it. Like, this is what came to me, like, very strongly to communicate to you. Yeah, I mean, and you know, like, I just understand. I just went with it, you know. So, but like, but someone said, go ahead with it this way. Like, I mean, I tell her this. And the energy that was so strong that I knew that I had to follow that energy and just do it. You know. But you're welcome, though. I appreciate it. Yeah.
Well, I appreciate you. Thank you so much.
No problem.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Have a good evening.
Yeah, you too. You too. See, sometimes certain people call in, and what ends up happening during that call turns out to be something that everybody else listening or calling in or both will get, and they open up to it. And you know, you have to open your heart. I saw that. It was like a tree with a bird's nest in it, like a little hole in the oak tree, in one part of it, where sparrows have laid eggs. And this straw, one of the birds brought in grass and other things to make a nest for the female. And that little opening in the oak tree, that little hole. And this is what is coming to me to say for some reason before I do the next call. But that little oak tree sprouts out, and it just starts as a little acorn coming from a pigeon. I guess you could say a progenitor or something like that, like an ancestor before it. Another example of that genetic lineage of, for example, a tree, or it might be a tomato plant, or some whatever it is, a person, and a mouse, a cat, a dog, a mountain lion, whatever it is. It's all just a little structure of molecules. And it's not hard to manipulate those molecules. And that's what mind of the matter is about. I get that. All right, let me keep on going here. Like, I felt that. Let's go to first person. Hi, you still there? How you doing tonight?
Hi, thank you very much for taking my call. I appreciate it.
No problem.
My name is Wendy, and the good news is that I start training with a real good job on the 18th day of this month. It's call center, and it's medical insurance. And I hope and pray that I understand the computer navigation and that I pass the 7 weeks training. And I have some other concerns. Am I going to be able to keep this job for at least 2 years?
Okay. Why is there a two-year benchmark again?
Well, I would prefer that I keep it around 11, but I'm 66. And if I can keep it a minimum of 2 years, then I can build up my Social Security so I'd have a little bit more money at hand when I start drawing. And I don't want to touch my Social Security until I absolutely have to. So that's why I'm so worried that I hope that I keep this job at least 2 years. 4 years would be a lot better.
Well, I mean, this is what I get, is that it's at this moment, there's a lot of different factors open still, but a lot of different paths that you could end up taking on the job that affect how long you have it. For example, what if one day, you and your boss get in an argument over a call, in the middle of the day, and it happens out of nowhere, and that affects the outcome of how long you have the job, and it's just because she's in a bad mood because of something that happened the night before with her boyfriend, let's say, or with the custody of one of a kid or something like that, whatever it might be. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Oh, I know exactly what you're saying, and I'm going to be very low-key and not take anything personally, and if that were to happen, I would just be very respectful and take notes and accept what she had to say, and so I would, because I need employment so much, I would just be very agreeable, I guess is the word.
And that was just one example, that could happen. I mean, there's many, many other things. But because, think about it, the next 2 more years or 4 more years, there's so much up in the air based on other people's behavior. People coming in bad mood, and their bad mood causes them to yell at somebody unnecessarily.
Yeah.
And think of that.
Very
then,
well
then
said.
That
based on other people's behavior is a big thing.
Exactly. I mean, hell, it could be somebody frowning instead of at the one of the consoles, one of the cubicles, at a call, and the boss comes in with a frown and doesn't say anything, and then yet it still affects people because they're looking at their frown thinking, oh, crap, Larry or Lindsay or whoever, or Barbara's in a bad mood, or Wanda's pissed, and she, or Dave's not happy, it looks like he's got a hangover. Office. Yeah, I see that. But if there's so much in the air, there's so much
it's
hard to answer that for me.
I've been in the business.
It's possible.
About
let me tell
years,
you, it's
so.
Possible. You're strong of will. You have a strong will. So it is, something like that is possible. You said 4 years. You can make it happen. You just be strong of will. Even more so than you are now.
4 years have put me in pretty good shape, actually. So, but do you see me still with this company? Let me see. I'm starting the training on September the 18th. So, will I still be with the company on December 1st of this year?
Well, it's something's up in the air here, and I see what it is. It's during training, the competitiveness of people and that environment, to get ahead in which training is complete. And I could see like you get in overly competitive, you know, with fellow trainees, some of them. Yes, and then they're doing the same sometimes. You understand what I'm saying? But I see a scene like where it's training, and then people are just like, you know, I got to get up here. I can't sit here in one position and a company. I want to move up regardless of what company it is. Are you happy with mm-hmm. your current company right now?
Well, I have to face the fact. I'm extremely lucky at age 66 to be hired directly from a large company like this with full benefits. And I've been looking for work for a long time. So I think that in the real world, I have to look at it like, if I could pick my job anywhere, I'd probably pick it somewhere else. But in life, it doesn't always work that way. So this is a similar environment to what I've done for over 15 years. And I think I'm definitely smart enough, but I know that there's always politics, and I don't play politics. I'm pretty quiet, and I just want to go in, do my job, and go home and be polite to everybody, really. I just want to make sure that I understand their computer navigation and that they the first step is to get through the training, which is about 7 weeks. So,
and what I was talking about with the training was that you could be pulled in almost like, you know, without a choice into office politics, you know, by certain events where you mm-hmm. didn't have any choice but to engage in that.
Oh, I know. I've seen a lot of things happen in the call center. Well, I'm going to go in there and just be quiet and keep my mouth shut and not take things personally. I may take it personally, but I'll keep it to myself. I won't talk to anybody else. And I'll just do my best. I'll work as hard as I can to learn. And I just pray to God I keep it minimum 2 years. 4 years would be fabulous. And my other concern is I don't have a lot of savings anymore. And I am in trouble with my credit cards. So even with my new paycheck, I can meet my regular monthly expenses, but I wouldn't be able to pay my credit cards anymore. So I've talked to three companies regarding debt settlement, and it would cost me just under $500 a month extra to make the payments on that, and then they negotiate with the creditors. And I think probably I would be approved for that. But my savings would last me almost a year. The program takes about 4 years. So the good news is it would not be a bankruptcy on my credit score. And I don't know if my sister is going to want to continue to sign a new lease with me next summer. If she does, that would be a big help to both of us to split expenses. I could do a Chapter 7 most likely, but then it would be difficult to find somebody to rent to me all by myself after a fresh bankruptcy. You have to wait at least a few years. So I have to make a decision whether or not to do the Chapter 7 or this credit card settlement. What do you think?
But the thing is, you can figure, like, you don't have to be like this bankruptcy. That's what I keep getting. But like that, you can. But the thing is, that's on you. And if you work it out right, you work it out with each company, yourself, and like to an agreement. Because think about like how you could cut little small expenses out of everyday living, little things that come up that you buy, you know, or and whatever, so stuff like that. Like, think about mm-hmm. that. A few dollars here, a few dollars there, adds up. And,
oh, you mean do my own negotiation?
Yeah, and also take a few dollars here and there out of what you're already doing.
Yeah. I don't think they'd be very receptive to me. I think that if they deal with more of the hard hitters, the companies, that they would recognize that they'd pay more attention. And my credit is not bad right now, and they're saying I'd have to stop paying my creditors completely to give them incentive to deal. So, but I just won't have the money.
Yeah, but the thing is, why sacrifice a good credit, when you have that choice? When it's pretty good, why sacrifice that, for something that may or may not be? The kind of security you're looking for, within yourself about finances and work future benefits.
I don't want to sacrifice security. So, to not sacrifice security, what would that mean? Are you saying Chapter 7 or the credit card?
No, I'm
settlement?
Saying like don't worry about what's going to happen with me so much. I keep feeling to say that, don't worry so much about some of this stuff, because it'll work out on its own in the end. So back and don't have anxiety about it. It'll work
well
out.
Well, I've actually, my creditors have really been paid back by me. Right now I'm just paying interest with my monthly payments, really. So it's not really that they're losing anything. I hate to change my behavior and not pay them, but that's going to happen, unfortunately, and I'm not the only person in the world. So I just pray to God that I'm guided, because I'll be making my decision this week which way I'm going to go. And but I really appreciate you speaking to me. That was very nice.
You don't have to do this that way. And so, but you can't. It's up to you. So,
well, I don't see how, if there's another avenue, then that's great. I have a telephone appointment with a lady who's a financial expert on the phone on Monday. So maybe she knows of an option that I'm not aware of, and that would be great.
I mean, I didn't specifically mention her. But you brought it up, and when you brought it up, I sense there's merit there to it. That person that was doing what you were talking about, bringing it up. So definitely a good idea. So, it can be that particular person for some reason, and a sense of it that for a good thing. It's a good thing. So,
I'll be making my decision probably around Wednesday or so of this coming week, and I'm putting it in God's hands. And my worry is what would happen next summer when the lease is up here. We could always renew where we are, most likely, because we pay the rent beautifully. But if my sister wants to move elsewhere and get her own apartment, then I don't know who would rent to me. Even though my rent would show perfect, a lot of landlords are going to see that Chapter 7 if I do that. And Lord help me, I don't know who would rent to me.
Well, no, plenty of people. If that means, and that's not certain that's going to happen. Yeah, I see that firmly. That's a possibility, sure. But
do you think people would rent to me?
But people would rent to you. There's plenty of places. They're not hard to find. Plenty of places for rent. Just go on Craigslist, for example, and for rent section of housing, for whatever city you're in, and it'll pull. You'll find there's tons of places. The apartment guide or whatever it might be. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I've always paid my rent ever since I was out on my own perfectly. So I'm putting it in God's hands, and it was very nice of you to speak with me. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Have a good night.
You too. Take care.
Bye. All right. Let's see. Just give me 1 second here. But I'm just thinking about like certain cause, like and like, well, from everybody that I talk to, I learned something from. And I try to teach people things too when I can. And I mean, and other people taught me things and what they do, and surprise. And it's sometimes a surprise on who it is. It's sometimes you never expect what ends up coming, but it does come sometimes. But anyway, let's continue here. Hey, how are you doing tonight?
I'm fine.
No, you're breaking up on me. You saw that?
Better. Hello?
You there?
Yes, I am. Could you hear me?
Yeah. And the people in the background. So go ahead. How you doing tonight?
Really? I'm fine, I just want to see, I just got a lot that I'm just trying to figure out and sort out while I'm moving forward, and I just want to see what you pick up on the directions that I'm trying to move in.
So how do you like your work with this dude? Like,
how do I like my work?
How do you like working with them?
So you're breaking up. Let me change. Let me change your headset. We might have a better connection. Could you hear me better now?
Yeah, I'm talking about the people right there. The people you're around. And, working with them, do you enjoy it? Just being honest, send me a question. Somebody told me to ask you. And so I'm just rolling with what I got to say on that. But, do you enjoy, your line of work and so forth?
My line of work is very complicated.
I know, but that's what I've been looking at that. I'm looking at this stuff, and I've seen it many times before. I get it. That's where this is what you ended up doing, and you're rolling with it, for the moment. And you've realized what you're doing. And it's all good. I don't judge, but I always point out what comes to me intuitively. And that's what comes to me intuitively about you, in part. And you know what I'm talking about. And you say it's complicated, but it's not in reality.
So I can make it easier. Is that what you're saying?
I know, but you didn't want to explain it to me, yourself. Okay. But the point is, I understand that. I see, you talked about line of work, the tone of voice you want. You said, then, it's very complicated. It meant that you got it already, what it meant. But you were trying to decide whether or not to bring it up, right? The details. You get it, but I get it. I understand. But why that line of work? I won't say it, but right now. But it's complicated. What makes it complicated?
Well, the structure makes it complicated, and the lack of organization and unrealistic expectations. And, you know, then there's the human factor. It's not really a...
like human factor, performance.
It's not necessarily a supportive environment.
Yeah, like human fallibility, but for example, and performance of what they're supposed to do in that line of work, their assigned duty. Like, you know what I mean? Like somebody calls in sick, or people like go out on their own and start going rogue, and like have the different splinter groups, basically, right? Like of people that follow different people and the structure of the organization. And you get it. But I mean, it's interesting. Like that, if you were dissatisfied with it, you wouldn't be there. And
well, you know, I always need to be self-sufficient and to at least handle my own.
How did you find out about this work? I've
been doing this work for many years. I just recently changed a job position this week, though within the same line of work. It's just a different classification. It's not necessarily a new job. It's just a different title in a job. Same level, but different title. Same level of pay, everything. It's just a different setting. Same location.
Yeah, no, I get that. Yeah. Like a promotion might put somebody in the office on like a different part of the building and stuff like that. One example, you know, I get it, or just reassignment, you know, with somebody else or a different working group, I get it, you know.
I'm just concerned how it would affect my personal life this year, because I have some challenges that I do want to take care of on the personal front, and my work has always gotten in the way because of the workload, and I'm just seeing what
running around, like traveling all the time, like you've got to go places a lot, you know, or you're working late, you know, or doing this or that, or out of town sometimes, and it's hard to explain to people back home, your family sometimes. I see, I had to do this and that, and you know, that it's not true what you're saying, you know, all of it, but you're telling the kids and so forth, other family members, like, you know, what you've been told to tell people, right? The cover story, you know, that people get, you know, the cover for what they're really doing. And it said that could be a compartment too. Like right there, that leads to higher ones, and the lower ones have no idea that the higher up compartments, you can call them, and then vice versa, going down, like have they think that they're at the top, but then they're not, and you understand? Yes.
Well, I had a supervisor that really gave me a hard time last year. She was a new supervisor, and she really wasn't supportive. It's like from day one, she wasn't trying to guide me correctly. It's like she had a vendetta, and recently she got demoted, and she was trying to get back the same job that I had, but eventually she just left. So I don't know if she left because she got demoted, but she really did me really rotten, and I'm finding out now that it was a lie that she did to a lot of people. So I don't know if management realized that, and they just did something about it. You know, I'm not really sure what
people
happened.
Sometimes they're like driven to quit. I see that cycle, like that where management is like sometimes like by their actions towards that in particular, employee of theirs, like give them a signal, but like that, like, well, you need to quit, you're not doing any good here, and so forth. And like sometimes, like management lays it out hard on that. So, and somebody gets promoted who shouldn't be promoted, for example, and nonetheless they get promoted, and the person who should have been promoted now doesn't get promoted sometimes. And I'm looking at the politics of this. It really is politics. And other people, like, you know, listen, will understand too. But it's like I'm just engaging with that, whoever calls in, you know? Just like I'm with you, like, I'm telling you what comes to me. So, I always hope, more than hope, I know that it's going to benefit somebody along the line, the show, when they hear it, even if it's a playback of the recording. And therefore, like, whoever it is, like, I try to use it as a teaching moment for a lot of people. That's something else. I mean, if there's office infighting and you move to a different section of the same line of work, and there's infighting there between people, again, just like last time, there's infighting everywhere. I see that. And it's a constant battle of wills sometimes with a nasty boss, for example. like somebody just pulling on you, it could be literal, or just somebody pulling on you in the sense that you better get this done, that this or that way, or else I'm going to tell Bob that you didn't meet minimum standards on your review and so forth. It's a mess. That's what I had to feel to call it. That it's a mess, but it's interesting watching the infight that goes on.
And I'm tired of infighting because I have enough things that I have to take care of. To me, the infighting is it's so counterproductive, and it's nerve wracking.
They don't realize the mission. They don't. A lot of people forget the bigger picture.
Mm-hmm.
And in any line of work and whatever people do, there's everybody always has moments where that they slip up on something, and for a moment, it's like they forget almost that shit. I'm supposed to be this or that way, and I got to do this, and I gotta kiss my boss's ass, even though I don't want to. But she doesn't have to know consciously. I just do it in other ways, and stuff like that. I mean, it's like I tell people. I use the example. One example I use the most, actually, is playing cards, and especially stuff like bridge or spades. Games like that, where you have a partner playing with you. And when I have when my partner in the spade game, for example, like if somebody hasn't played with me before, or everybody else, doesn't know my style of playing card games, it's psychological, like putting out the message of weakness. That's what I do. Sometimes I put it out as a signal to them, I'll tip my hand a card, for example, in situations like that, just a little bit to their own purpose, and make it and just pretend like it's accidental, and then see how my partner reacts and the others react on the opposite side on that card game. And just keep looking at that. I watch their reactions too. Like I'll purposely lose the hand. I could have won a particular hand.
Right. I think I did that last year. That's at one point I was so frustrated I did that. I actually had to do
so
that.
So you draw
and,
people in. You draw people in. You draw
did
people
draw
in. All of us, like whenever you do something like that, you draw people in. And to that.
Is that
to
a
that
good
way.
Thing or a bad thing, though?
It's a.
Go ahead. Got into a place I didn't even want to be around anybody.
Well, it depends on what someone's end goal in doing that is. That's, you know, that's what I see. It's really up to them, like, and what they're trying to achieve out of it. And that's why I ask people if they enjoy their jobs so much, because so many people do what they hate for a living instead of something they love. You see what I'm getting at?
Yeah. Could I ask you a question, though? Are you
sure.
Are you able to look into some dynamics that I have with my relatives? There's some business that I need to be taking care of, but there's some people that are in the way, and I'm not sure if, you know, they're ready to move on and do the right thing.
Well, with relatives, relatives are a pain to deal with, I know, sometimes. Like, not every time, but a lot of the time. So, and especially when you can't tell them the full truth, right?
Well, the only thing that I'm really hiding at this point is what my next steps are, because they've been deceptive.
And so they don't trust you, you don't trust them. I see.
No, we're in a very adversarial situation, and it's been several years now. And they've been very deceptive and dishonest. So I have no reason to just like lay all my cards out on the table. I'm in a position now where I'm trying to protect my interests.
But I didn't finish like with my example, though. With the cards. There's another part to it. Everybody, I'll screw up one particular hand on purpose. You know, so everybody thinks that I'm new at cards, for example. I'm new at playing cards when I'm not. And everybody's been hoodwinked into thinking of looking at him. He lost that hand, and he should have won, and, you know, and I knew that. So I used that, misunderstanding, almost against them, you know. But it's not against them, but it's to win the game, whatever type of card game it is, spades, bridge, whatever. But when you do it like that, and when it's psychological, when you lead people to think that you're easily defeated, that you don't understand how to play, and stuff like that, when you really do, and then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, you bring it out. You know, you start showing people out of nowhere, everyone, how good you are. And then, you just start winning hand after hand of cards by doing that. That's what I'm talking about. Stuff like that. That was the second part of the example. You there?
Yes, I'm here.
Do you understand that part?
I understand some of it. Someone actually walked in and interrupted me halfway through, and I apologize for that. But, you know, I figure when you play a game of cards or something like that, you do that for enjoyment. Life is not a game unless you're really enjoying it. And
I never said life like wasn't a game, but in a sense it is a game too. Like because of it, there is a part of life that is a game. And but it's serious, but it's also a game at the same time. But it's also like you're also all business as well as a being.
Okay.
And there's no need to worry so much about what they think. I mean, if what they think is up and down, if they don't like what you think or what you do, there might come a time where to move on. And
well, I am trying to move on. I'm trying to get some resolution, and I'm just concerned if my main concern are they're gonna finally do the right thing.
Well, you will. You know, you will. Trust in that. You will. The time will come where you'll understand your role and like in the greater good with your relatives, with other people. And if you play it right, the time is not far off.
It's not far off?
It's not far off if you don't make it like that by your actions.
Well, I'm trying not to, but it's like that's my thing. It's been feeling like I'm playing this game. I have to play in a game that I don't like. And to me, it shouldn't be a game. These are serious things that need to be taken care of. And it's not even about me anymore. It's about, you know, the next generation.
Yep. That's true. Like that, I mean, you're right about that. It is about like what's coming up, who's coming up, and the society and this population and the world. I get it. But anyway, I mean, I gotta go to the next call. Like I got some. Yeah, I apologize, but I hope that think about what I said there. Think about what
yes,
I said.
I'm going to listen to the archive again. I appreciate you taking so much time. Thank you.
No problem. All right. Bye-bye. All right. Let's see. But what I was getting at with the example with cards, it's basically you're leading like somebody into and play God. Ambush, sort of, in a sense, because you're ambushing them with truth, and some people just like they can't handle like the stuff you say, but I say it anyway, and but like I said, she'll get it too. She'll understand. I see that. I'm just picking up any call that comes to me first for some reason. There we go. Hello. How are you doing?
Hi. Good. I'm doing good. Thank you. Thank you for taking my call.
Oh, you're welcome. Thanks for calling back. Go ahead.
So, I would like an objective perspective on my relationship with Brian, if you could.
Well, why, like you've been told to ask this question, actually, I get it, you know, you wish it was different, but like you fantasize. There is some truth to it. Like
there's ones you have fantasies about at work, and wish if the things were different, that so-and-so wasn't your supervisor or this and that, or someone higher up. Like, you know, everybody goes through that. And you get what I'm saying? Like, what I'm, yeah, I understand.
Yeah, I mean, I wish things were different with my relationship with Brian, for sure. And
I'm talking about, like, so, but he's right with you a lot of the time, even, like, you know, there's people there now. I mean, Brian's in the house, or going to be soon. You know, I get his energy now. Like this one you're talking about, you know, this particular being. Like, even though it's like almost like how you wish things were, you're just using the how you wish it, right? Like, for what you need to tell, what you're supposed to say, right? You get instructions on what to say. I understand. That's what I've been talking about with other people earlier. Like, you know, like on the same wavelength of work. So, yeah, you know what I mean? So, I just say it as it is. But anyway, I mean, but why, who came up with, like, but how, like, you came up with that particular thing with Brian, or did someone else order?
Well, that's an interesting question, because, I mean, I probably would have asked a different question, but I do want to phrase things to be productive. And so that's why I phrased it that way. Instead,
so when you look back on it and see, you know, like when you phrase it that way, the different, you know, I'm still tuned in, yeah, it's one of these nights, like I was expecting something like this. That's why I put up this show right after doing another show. Not that long, like an hour before that, finishing one up on a different subject. But I wanted to see, like, if it was going to be the same kind of thing in Pasture, and here we are. It's cool in a way, because once again, like, the more people try to disrupt things. I'm not saying anybody in particular here. You know, although I could be, you never know. I mean, but this is a message to everybody listening, is that I understand, I get things that I don't tell people I get. I do that all the time. I mean, a lot of stuff comes to me intuitively that I've never told anybody. Like, you get stuff, all kinds of information on people, and they don't need to be around you, you don't need a picture, you don't need, but energy that they put off. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, so
doing this makes you happy, I mean, certain things in life make you happy. I see that. Like, because the pay is good. I get that. Like, that was just on your mind, like, thinking about the pay, right? Something about the pay. Like, it's coming on that and looking. Like, that's a major incentive for this, right?
The pay for my job. Yeah, I mean, I'm happy with my job. Pay could be better, but it's good for me right now. I prayed for this job. I got this job. I appreciate this job. I like the job.
I never said you didn't. Like I'm just asking, like who introduced you to that type of work? A friend or
I literally prayed for. I literally prayed for it, and I went on Craigslist.
How'd you hear about it the first place on Facebook? And then that's when you started to pray, you say?
Craigslist.
Hmm. Like, I heard something about praying just so, like, before that for some
reason. Yeah, I did. I really needed a job badly so that I could have
you
medical
heard about
care.
It and you heard about it on Facebook, but Facebook had ads up too. That's what I keep getting. No wonder I keep thinking about Facebook. Random ads went up on Facebook for that, and to see who would respond. So that's interesting. And we're talking about as well. But it's interesting talking with people who do that kind of work. This is why this is interesting. So you never know who's going to end up saying what and doing what, you know? It's interesting, and it makes it fun for me, you know? And I know it helps in one way or another, you know? So... Are you still there? Yeah, you're still there.
Yeah, I am.
Anyway, go ahead. Yeah,
I'm listening. I just have... noises going on.
Go ahead.
Noises that I'm trying to mute so that it doesn't come off and I'm so sorry about that. Like I was putting on you on mute so that you couldn't hear it, and then.
I was there
at the peak.
and then I corrected myself because I sensed it anyway.
Yeah,
like,
you said I was.
It's the same environment. Listening. That you've been in before when we've talked, you know, like where you muted the calls and stuff like that. I know, you know, like I get it. So, so how's everything going?
So say that again.
How's everything been going, though? Yeah, I ain't talked to you in a while. Until tonight.
You're right. No, I mean, maybe the question I should really ask is how I can improve communication with Brian, because things fell apart faster than I wanted to, but maybe that was just
How's the show going? And are you still doing the same radio shows and shit?
I haven't done a radio show for 6 years.
Well, yeah. You've done them since then. Last summer, you've been on shows with me. You've done I've been on. You said too last summer, remember?
No, I don't remember because.
You do. But Wendy is cool, it's all good. I mean, like, that's why I was talking about, like, the same environment and all that, too. Like, I can accept you, you know? That's why, like, I was bringing up things I was bringing up. So, you know, anyway, so you've been all right, but...
Yeah.
Cool. So, go ahead.
Go ahead. Well, so, I guess, can I rephrase my question?
Well, why are you asking about Brian so much when there's so many other things out there, like, to ask about? For intuitive stuff.
I guess because he's on my mind the most.
So work isn't on your mind more than Brian, right? Or no?
I just do
mind.
Work all the time. I do work all the time, but
no.
It's not really on my mind. Money's on my mind. Got money on my mind.
I know.
But I just figure if I keep working that the money will keep going.
No, like money keeps coming in. You know, I mean, I wish I had more money personally. You know, but like just off subject. You know, it'd be nice. But like, you know, whenever things like that happen, that they will. That's the way I look at it. Violent situation, like, you know, so, yeah, I understand, like, but, anyway, though, like, look at all these duplicate mothers, you know, it's just, like, so clear, like, one of these, like, but that's, I'm just rolling through stuff, rolling through calls, like, but all the duplicate numbers that are on here. some disappear, some reappear. I've been noticing that. And there's always that all ones number that comes up at one point or another in this. Like it's 111111 on the call list. But anyway, let me hop over and see what happens next here. Like, hold on for just a second. See, on shows like this, you never know. Like, you get all these callers who, for lack of a better word, you know, repeat. You know, like this is we repeat. But then again, let's see.
Okay.
You still there? Hello? What?
Hello?
Oh, hey, how you doing tonight?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Oh, I'm good. I'm doing good.
Yes, sir.
You're breaking up.
I'm sorry. I was just calling in tonight to get a general reading.
And like you know that call center, like that's those cubicles and stuff again. I mean, I'm gonna roll with what's coming. Let me just say, like you heard me with other people. This is how I do it. I see that office with the cubicles and my call center type environment. I mean, sound familiar?
Sorry.
In that cubicle that you're in, you know, that you work, you know, in the office. And I mean, like, I mean, how many cubicles per row are there?
12.
Yeah, your phone must be breaking up. Can you hear me all right?
Yes, sir, I can hear you fine. I answered the question. I said 12.
Okay, and, like, y'all have, like different offices everywhere. That's interesting. It could be the most inconspicuous-looking office building with offices for rent that has, like, important companies for it based in there. And for, or with stuff like that, whatever it might be, company or other things. And that's the only thing, like, I got to see, like, I like the architects, there's an interest. They're, like, in 12 cubicles per row. And you said 12. Okay.
I said 12.
And so, like, how'd you find that your job? Like, Facebook, Craigslist, or other sources?
Found out that I was
Yeah. I mean, how'd you find that work? How'd you hear about it in the first place?
How did I find the 12?
How'd you find, like, your current job?
My current job?
Yeah.
I'm not actually working. I'm disabled.
Okay. Now, but you said 12 cubicles. Like, where?
Well,
when
my,
I said,
in the room.
Go ahead. I just had the laugh. So this, like, it's interesting. It's not nothing personal with anyone or anything. It's just, this is interesting. But keep going.
All right.
But there's 12 cubicles. Like, you brought that up. Like, and when I asked, like, where you're currently sitting, like, you know, in that row, and each row, like, nearby two, like, what's, you know, basically, how many are each row? And 12 cubicle workstations, you know, this was your response. And then I asked again, just to make sure, and then you said, you agreed, 12. And you said, yeah. And then you said, like, oh, I'm not working. Like, after that, I'm just pointing that out. So
okay. Can you tell me anything else?
Well, why are you, like, so you're getting paid to call in, you know, this company?
No, I'm not a mystery caller, sir. Actually, I'm calling because I wanted a reading.
Well, you see, like, you're doing this.
I apologize for interrupting your show.
Look at this, that's not any way to speak to a caller
that's calling into a show.
I'm not going to fall for that. I don't fall for that. Like, you know, you're playing that particular card.
Because you're being very rude.
Well, the thing is, you're like saying one thing 1 minute, and then the next minute you're denying it. Like, let me throw that out. Yeah. I'm not trying to be rude. I'm trying to point out obvious things, and it's right on the recording. I mean, on the archival recording. I mean, and people listening heard it. And I understand playing that card. You know, you're rude, and, you know, like, that method, you know, like, dealing with that. See, they hung up, you know, like, and I knew that, too. I just wanted to point it out to anybody who isn't out there. Like, he's working for this particular company that has trained, you know, professional trolls to disrupt certain things online. Like, and it's like a contract. Like, so many of these calls here are, not everybody, but a lot. But yet, I answer them anywhere. I like certain ones. fight, just fight for fun. You know, just to point certain things out. I thought so. See, like, you know, that it's like, just like that duplicate number earlier, it's still at the top on hold. But that's the master number for certain, a lot of the other numbers connected. I just saw that, so I did. Because during this whole show, it's been changing hold times, even though I've never answered that particular number yet. So therefore, I need to match up the hold times with other hold times of other numbers that come up with that main one. As if it changes, try to match it up. But it's at 37.26. Well, that's a lot. 2015, and he's the guy's playing the "you're very rude" card that he was trained in and trolling. That's funny, you know. But it's nothing personal. I said, like, he's just mad to get called out. I mean, like, that's the way it is with stuff like that, and I have to point it out. That's as you heard me say, and so it'll be hung up. You guys, you try to help people, man, and this is what happens. Now, some people are just listening. Let's see. Let's start out like a little different here. All right. Let's start out different and see what happens. Hold on 1 second. Give me 1 second. Fix this. All right, there we go. I just wanted to clear, you know, like someone told me intuitively clear that who's on hold. Like, I knew it's clear that lots connected. And then the people who, certain people, like, will call back in, like it's happening now, you know. And sometimes you got to do that to refresh things on Twitch for us. That's what you got to do on this radio platform on Blackout sometimes. And look, okay, I'm going to sit here and say, you know, the sea calls in first, like, further than this, and then start again. Until then, I'm going to talk about some other things here. One second. I'm looking at this, and then the more that caller is trying to do certain things, like that guy back then, like playing games, you know, admit it 1 second, behind it the next, and the other ones, he answered the cubicle question and then denied it, and hopefully the tape is well, not the physical tape, obviously, but the recording. And it has both sides on it. I'm still the guy, that guy laughing, like, trying to, and, like, he thought he was going to, I wasn't going to notice him. Like he's one. The same silence, the same buzzing noises, and with other callers too. That with him, like mute, then suddenly on. And then I saw clearly that call center is working for or a company that does this. And to me, the other callers had too. But that's fun. You know, I'm going to see who else calls in. And here we go again. You know, let's I knew it, but there are people honestly listening out there and taking something in from this. Even the oppo and trolls and minions that listen and or call in are getting hit with energy from me. I do project energy through spoken word. Everybody does. The different levels of projection. It could be super strong. It could be it could be weak. But let's keep watching. Like this switchboard for just a minute. Let's see what happens before we keep going. But having all the the trolling stuff going on tonight, a lot of calls, is indicative of me being on the right path. Yet again, just like in the past, shows like this can disrupt it with troll calls and legit calls being filtered out a lot of the time. And that's what's going on tonight. All these duplicate numbers, and as those listening who are on can be honest about it to themselves, that what they heard, and playing back the recording, I said, hopefully caught both sides of the recording, my voice and theirs. Since people early on brought up that they were having a hard time, but they were minions to the oppo, calling them to disrupt. I'm just waiting on some honest callers as I sense the call, who truly could use help, who aren't sitting there as paid trolls and so forth to call in. And I'm still waiting. And I'm and I'm not saying people on the switchboard are this or that, but I'm waiting on something I sense needs to be answered, and it's being filtered out. People are trying to call in. I mean, hell, I've had shows on Blog Talk. There's one last summer, maybe two, that I couldn't log in to the show when it was about to start. It just said, the servers overloaded. When I went to another computer, it wasn't overloaded. And it wasn't overloaded until I tried to log in. And then it just shut down completely. So, I don't care. I'm going to sit here and see if, the filter lit up. And the oppo is going to let somebody actually call and who is independent, who isn't with anybody, isn't serving anybody, any cause, anything like that. And we'll see. But I doubt it. So therefore, we're going to do this. Even though there's time left, might end for now and then pick back up shortly on something else of similar here on another show. But even if that show is that too, same kind of thing happened. And It's cool. It's everything in the universe is meant to be. Yeah, it all leads to something positive. On that note, I'll leave that this particular show a little early, and we'll see about doing another one shortly. See if there's as much much troll activity and so forth as now.